I have to play the game of his life here. But maybe today is that day. Just a young man. Still emerging onto the scene, really. Age 20.
Good start for him here too. Nice backhand cross court. Feel like that's going to be an area that he'll have to exploit if he wants to have a chance.
Comparisons between the two are on paper are numerous, and one of them is quite illuminating. Ma Long, 52 career titles. Hiroto Shinazuka, 2 career titles. Now, there's 15 years of difference between the pair, and that, of course, accounts for some of that, I'm sure, but 52 times he has been a champion.
I think what that displays, though, Jack, is just how good Shinazuka is. There's not many people with titles and multiple titles at that age and at that ranking.
Great point.
That proves he's a winner. So can he bring that to the table today?
People would be surprised that Shinsuke Togami is not playing. He was, of course, in the team 2 years ago in Chengdu. But Togami has not played at all here.
Interestingly enough, on the team selection, Japan have actually announced and selected their Olympic team already, which consists of Togami. So we have to feel that there's an issue with him, that he's not able to be here at the championships.
Setting out his stall, but Shinazuka equal to it.
They're very calm here, Shinazuka, just holding him, holding his ground, waiting for a chance, and then snap with a backhand.
Japanese bench loving this beginning from Shinazuka. First game has gone the way of both Matsushima and Harimoto in their respective matches. They've been starting well, and Shinazuka following suit. This is impressive, deeply impressive.
Yeah, really strong play. Again, Japanese style, going for broke, serving long, turning the corner almost before Ma Long hit the shot.
Six, eight. Everyone on their feet for Ma Long. What is it about him, Gavin, for you that makes him the greatest of all time? Technically, what are his key strengths?
I think what I can say about Ma Long is I don't see any weaknesses. I don't see there's an area of his game that's exploitable.
Pulls this back, doesn't he? Just as Shinazuka was getting ahead of steam up.
Ma Long clearly has an incredible forehand, but also he's adapted his game as the years have gone on. Now we see so much more backhand to backhand and backhand flicks from receive. Ma Long has lived through that generation and adapted his game.
Oh. Case in point.
Take over the table there, Shinazuka. Set himself up with half a chance. Ball slightly up. Full power over the table. Each one of those balls and play forehand. Super impressive.
And he loved it as well, bouncing around on his toes, fist pumping in the air. Game point. Ma Long takes it. Aim to the body of Shinazuka.
And I think that was more down to an absence from the tour for a period of time rather than actually any losses.
To have an absence and still only drop to 12.
Yeah, pretty impressive, isn't it?
Yeah.
But I mean, you could talk in superlatives about Ma Long all day. Switch there. Ma Long was anticipating and already turning the corner on the backhand side. And Shinazuka just able to see it in time and straight down the line.
Three, one.
Shinazuka rocked backwards in the point by Ma Long here.
Yeah, just forcing him back. He's so quick to finish points, Ma Long.
Got it! 4-1.
Stepping forward and finding life a bit easier in game two.
Yeah, just such good chance creation there with the service. And straight over the table, punishing with a forehand. And he's on a roll here now.
One, six.
Keeps coming. Shinazuka struggling for a foothold. Well, that's much better.
6-2.
And that will feel good. Shinazuka.
He did well to stay in this point, to be honest. Ma Long looked favourite the whole way through.
It's 35 now, Gavin, and how long would you expect someone with Marlon's career to potentially go on for? How many years has he got in the tank still?
I think his body is not letting him down. He's clearly in great shape. He's clearly looked after himself. He's clearly still got the table on his level. But I would be surprised if we see Marlon for too much longer in the Chinese team. I think potentially the Summer Games might be the last time we see him.
China, unlike Japan, not yet naming their team for that too.
No, we don't know exactly who's going to be there in Paris for China, but you wouldn't look past the three that they have here.
You're absolutely right. Whoever they select, they're going to be the players to beat, as they always are.
Yeah, and probably a more interesting decision on the Chinese side is who plays the singles event, as they can only take two of that three. So, do you leave out the world number one, two, or three?
I'm sure they've asked themselves that question.
Or four or five?
Yep, there's a wide choice there. Lin Gao Yuan, Liang Jingkun. Not quite at the level, are they? Although, Lin Gao Yuan has beaten Ma Long very recently for the first time in his career. Got to stick to his task here, Hiroto Shinazuka, and believe him, good luck, believe that there might be some fortune that lies ahead if he can just somehow claw his way towards Ma Long. And maybe it's not in this game, but he's got to begin again in game three. Five game points. And Ma Long again only needs one of them. Well, this is it for Shinazuka now. And for Japan, trailing China two matches to love in the quarterfinals. And that's smart from Shinazuka, just punching into Ma Long's body.
Yeah, just a nice bit of extra pressure on that block, forcing a mistake from Ma Long. He's got to start finding those flicks, though, if he wants to turn this around.
Brilliant scrambling. It's absolutely brilliant.
It's just relentless play from both sides. Shinazuka doing everything to try and win that point, and Ma Long just will not go away.
We've said that a few times about the Chinese players, haven't we?
Relentless.
Putting them away once in a rally just isn't enough.
3-2.
Marlon punching that backhand, but more than a punch, a sort of extended punch which shunts Shinazuka backwards. Just clipped the wings of Shinazuka, hasn't he, who got off to a flyer, winning the first 2 points. If a few cracks do emerge, he's got to take them.
It's the right way to play from Hirota Shinazuka. Just hasn't clicked for him on that final ball. And that's been the tale of a lot of this game for him, unfortunately.
Lovely shape to the body of Shinazuka there. He got so low. Marlon was ready for that backhand flick.
Time over the test of time, it's proven that Ma Long is the winner of the group. You know, they're all champions and great players in their own right, but Ma Long is the one with the most winning instinct, the killer instinct. So he's never going to let go of a situation like this. If Shinazuka wants to win, he's going to have to do something extraordinary to take this away from Ma Long. Still signs of life there in the Japanese camp. Lovely backhand. Really strong switch. And I would be surprised if we don't see a little bit more of that now. He's just going to have to go for broke even more than he already has. Oh, wow. Oh, that's lovely. little bit of fortune to finish us off there, but what a point. Shinazuka starting off in the ascendancy. All of a sudden, Ma Long took control. And then, with the help of a little net, Shinazuka nicks it.
Two behind, one up now.
Legend, 7-8.
This is significant. Big strides being taken towards this game now from Shinazuka.
I said it would take something extraordinary to get it out of Ma Long's chokehold, but Shinazuka's really stepped up the game now in the last few points, and he's done well to muster up this two-point lead.
I've been listening to you, Gavin, but he was probably listening to his coach, Tasai Kunahito, after that timeout.
Legend, 9-7.
Great chance, this. And a great chance becomes a must-take chance.
Received from Ma Long there. Just forced Shinazuka really far onto his forehand side, trying to take that backhand. Now he's got to keep Ma Long out here with the receive. Either go for broke with a flick, or it has to be low over the net.
Desperate to keep it low. Just misjudged it. One chance left. Till Ma Long is back on level terms. Always done it. Extraordinary required, and Hiroto Shinazuka. To see another one between these two.
Very good set, or very good start. Clear intentions. Yes.
Rips it.
Just a small apology. I think it nicked the edge on its way past Ma Long. But he won't be too worried about that for too long. Shinazuka opens up a lead here in the first.
Goodness me. What a momentum shift. Seven now of the last 9 points.
One, three.
What might be going through Ma Long's head, Gavin? I don't imagine there's too much worry there, given his experience, but what will he be thinking about?
Yeah, I think if Ma Long was a mere mortal, you might start to see signs of nerves, but I don't think that man is a mortal. So he'll just be focused on the job at hand, what he needs to do to kill this momentum that Shinazuka is on. And get back to what he does best, controlling and dominating.
Clear. Japan. Japan. Don't delay the match, please. 2-3.
Umpire just saying, Japan, don't delay the match. Obviously feeling that they're taking a little bit too long in between the points.
Into the net. Now it's Ma Long with the momentum.
Check the score from 3-0 to 5-3.
High risk, high reward strategy, but no reward for Shinozuka there.
I've seen that a few times now over the last exchange of points from Ma Long. That long serve deep into the Shinozuka backhand, just eliminating the chance of the banana flick. That has proved dangerous.
Oh, yeah.
4-6.
Swift reactions.
And Ma Long really going for broke there. Gave everything into the forehand, so no chance to recover. 5-0 China.
Urging him onwards towards this third game, but Shinozuka is playing his best stuff now.
A great backhand open there, so explosive cross court. Just too quick for Ma Long on that occasion. Not something we hear or say often.
He's really found his groove since going 2-love down. And then he was trailing Ma Long in the third. Looking for that lead again. All credit to the Ma Long serve there, Gavin, or unforced error from Shinozuka?
Yeah, it's a bit of both. I mean, Shinozuka has to take the chance. He has to go for it. But Ma Long's service placement, extremely good. Almost half long, almost short. Just a little bit of indecision on what to do from Shinozuka.
Taking Ma Long out in the duel.
Errors from Ma Long that we don't normally see. I'm not sure if that's a sign that he's feeling a little bit of pressure here in this situation.
Shinozuka rising.
9-7
now. Looking for his second game to level things up.
Leg 7-9.
Does get it done, Marlon. Shinazuka just tried to stay alive. It wasn't enough.
Clever little drop shot at one point there from Marlon. Not something orthodox, let's say. Well, proved effective.
A drop shot at the peak of the bounce. Healthy clip of the net, helps it long for Marlon. He gets to 9 each. Now Shinazuka is going to have to stay so strong mentally here. Because Marlon's been in this scenario so many times and come out on top.
Absolutely. Just going to try and create chances for himself here, Shinazuka, with the service. Give himself a shot at a third ball attack. Yes.
Marlon manages it, fielding the serve well and then exerting his authority on the point. Shinazuka did well again just to get up from that slip. But match point for Marlon and for China to seal a place in the semi-finals again. Marlon at the first attempt.